Hey guys, welcome back. My name's Maddie if you're new here, and today's video I am going to be reading as many Kindle Unlimited books in a week as possible. I filmed this video maybe a month or two ago and I powered through so many books and it was so fun and it made me fall in love with my Kindle because I just got a Kindle in April of this year. Unpopular opinion? Some Kindle Unlimited books are really good. Last time I filmed this video, I think in the video I only said that I did 3.5, but by the time I posted the video, I actually finished the fourth book on the last day of my week-long challenge. So my goal for this video is to beat that or read at least as many. Hopefully this isn't boring. And I'm gonna try to pick popular books that you guys have heard of. I'm starting this challenge on a Sunday and I'm going to be reading as many books as possible until Saturday night. So 1, 2, 3, let's get into the video. Game time. Hey guys, so I had the idea to film this video again for the second time and then I haven't filmed anything since I started this challenge on Sunday. It's now Tuesday. And honestly, it's because I'm reading a book right now that I don't like, but for the sake of the video, since I'm 70% through, I have to finish it so it counts as one book. And I also want to finish it because I saw Sarah Caroli and Heather McLary both gave this book 4 stars. So I'm holding out hope. Maybe the ending will wrap it up nicely into a better book. But it's called Our Scorching Summer. I've seen this book everywhere. I think the author's on TikTok. I love the cover of the book. The name is pretty clever too, based on the context of the book. And I think my problem with it is, well, first of all, she's a really good writer. Or is it two people? I think two people wrote this book. I'm not sure. The writing is really well done. It's just, sometimes I feel like there's too much context on stuff that doesn't matter, and then on another person's backstory, I'm like, wait, why is the person like this? Or maybe it's just because that part hasn't happened yet. But also, Our Scorching Summer is a friends to lovers trope, and I don't really like friends to lovers. My thing with friends is, if you're already friends and you like each other and you're falling for each other, then just be together. Just be together. It's not a high stakes fantasy romance book where these two families have been feuding for centuries and they can't be together. Like, it's not Romeo and Juliet. There's nothing keeping you apart except your own stubborn selves, so get over it and get together. Sorry, that was really heated, but I was just trying to dive deeper into why I actually didn't like this book so far, because it has all the elements of any other book that I do like, except that it's friends to lovers. No. I like enemies to lovers. I like when they overcome their hatred for each other and decide to be together. So, I don't know. Hopefully I'll finish this book tonight. And then also, since I was getting bored with this book, I started Freida McFadden's Never Lie book and I got 5% through, and then Sam came home and I stopped reading. But yeah, that's my update. 3 days into this challenge, have not finished one book. We'll see how it goes. Okay guys, 80% through the book and a cute moment has happened. I mean, there have been a few cute moments, but a moment I'll definitely remember from this book. So that's exciting. Still not my favorite book couple and still not fully buying into their relationship, but almost done. We'll give you the full review shortly. Hey guys, it's Wednesday and I finally finished my first book of this challenge. I have not been sleeping well, so I have not been reading. Just been too tired to do anything. I finished Our Scorching Summer, and honestly, if I wasn't doing this challenge, I probably would have DNF'd it. I wanted so hard to like this book. I really did. I didn't think the writing was bad at all. It just didn't flow for some reason with me, and I didn't really connect with the characters and their relationship. There were a lot of cute moments that I highlighted while I was reading it on my Kindle, but I don't know. I think I have to give it a 2.5. feel really bad for doing that because the writing was well done, but it didn't leave a lasting impression. I'm gonna get back to reading Never Lie by Freida McFadden, and hopefully I can finish that book by tomorrow so I at least finished 2 books in this challenge. Hey guys, just a little reading update. I am 30% through with Never Lie by Freda McFadden, and I just love reading her books. They're so easy to get through. They flow perfectly. There's a cliffhanger at the end of every chapter. I'm really enjoying it so far, and I don't know if I said this earlier, but I found out that Freda McFadden is a doctor that specializes in brain injuries, which for this specific book makes so much sense because one of the main characters is a psychiatrist, and she's talking about how people's brain works and stuff like that, and it's from her own personal knowledge. She didn't even have to research it, so that's cool. She's a writer, a doctor, and what am I? I'm gonna get back to reading this. See you guys later. Oh, Katie's picking me up because my car is getting fixed, and we're gonna go try out this new coffee shop in the downtown area, and then we're gonna come back here and read slash work. I'm excited. I don't need another coffee, but I am getting one.
My friend nostalgia, I found you when I heard the sweet sound of the ones who I once knew.
I'm 47% of the way through. Frida's books are so easy to read, and I love that. I love that. So maybe I will finish this tonight. We'll see. I'm gonna go make some popcorn because I'm hungry. Bye. Guys, I finished Never Lie by Freda McFadden. So basically I finished it in a day. I love Frida's books. They get you out of a slump. And I was definitely in the slump from the last book. Just love her books. I was about 80% through when I discovered what one of the twists was gonna be, and I caught it the chapter before because she dropped one more hint. It wasn't me figuring it out all along, but I'm proud of myself for that. And then the other twist was good. It was shocking. And the epilogue, her epilogues are always so haunting. Wow. I literally still think about the last sentence in the other book I read by her, The Inmate. She knows what she's doing. Her books are always trying to steer you the wrong way. She's always trying to trick you, and you know what? She does trick me. I'm glad I finished 2 books so far in this challenge, which means I'll definitely have time, hopefully, to finish a third book before Saturday, because Saturday will be the 7th day. But I do have plans Saturday morning and Saturday evening, so I don't know if I'm gonna get to read Saturday, so I just have Thursday and Friday left. I think I'm gonna read Done and Dusted next. I keep seeing it everywhere. It's a cowboy romance. I haven't read any of those because nothing really is calling to me, but I'm gonna try it because it's short and everybody loves it. This is the first sentence in the summary of Done and Dusted, which is a small town romance. She's off limits, but he's never been good at following the rules. Okay, maybe I will like this. The cover is cute. I mean, obviously I just have the Kindle version, but it's kind of old timey. So let's see how this goes. Hey guys. So it's Thursday night at 8:00. Just wanted to do a little update. I'm 50% through with Done and Dusted, and I am loving it. I love Luke. It's funny, I've laughed out loud 2 times. The writing's really easy to get through, and it's different from other romances I read, because normally I don't read small town romance. So I really like it, and I'm gonna cut myself off here because The Summer I Turned Pretty season 2 is out right now. I'm screaming. Crying, throwing up, pooping my pants. Let's go. Also, I feel like I'm not going to get a lot of reading done for this challenge now that this show came out. So, we'll see.
Shirt
and look disgusting, but I was just reading Done and Dusted. It still said I had less than an hour left. I think I was around 68% last time I checked,
And then I go to swipe to the next page and it says before you go, and it has like where you can give it 5 stars on Goodreads. And I'm like, that's weird, I must have just swiped something, right? So I go back and I swipe again. And it's over. How is it just over? I've never been more confused. I've seen in people's videos that it just ends abruptly, but I didn't realize it was gonna end at 70%. What? I mean, I can't give it 5 stars because I just don't know what happened, but I would give it 4 stars. It's good. I am so stupid, it is not over. I did that a few more times and it kept wanting me to rate it, but then finally it went to the next page. It did not end that abruptly. Back to reading and then I'll give you my full review soon. How did that happen? I swear I've left my room. Update, remember earlier when I thought I finished Done and Dusted, but I hadn't? I don't know what happened there, but I finished it now. Honestly, I think it's a 5-star read. If anything, a 4.5, but that's annoying. So I think I'm just gonna do 5 stars. I loved the length of the book. It wasn't too long, it wasn't too short. I loved the characters, their backstory. There was depth to them, there was plot. The spice was good, it was amazing. And I will read more books by that author for sure. And I could have sworn that somebody said this was the book that had an abrupt ending and they were like, wait, did my Kindle not download the rest of it? But then I went back and I watched a few videos of the people who I thought said that and I couldn't find it. So I imagined it, or they were talking about another book. That's why I thought when it ended abruptly that it was actually over. But really my Kindle was just glitching. That is so weird. It was literally saying like, rate this book now at 65%. And was like, before you go. So weird. Then I was having some trouble deciding what I wanted to read next, because I could A, either knock 2 books off my TBR list, or B, I recently found the Redheads podcast, which is led by, I think, Jackie from The Morning Toast, which I don't even listen to that, but I love a good podcast about reading. Go check out my podcast down below. And I like their podcast because they review books they've read and it's complete spoilers, so you can kind of see if they felt the same way you felt after reading a book. Except they've read a lot of books that I haven't read. So I noticed that Bright Side by Kim Holden was one of their books they talked about, and it was on Kindle Unlimited. So either that or 2 books that are on my TBR, Red, White, and Royal Blue, because I want to reread it before the movie comes out, or Divine Rivals. But both of those books were, I think, 8 hours on Kindle Unlimited, and Bright Side was 6.5, which is still a stretch. I don't think I can finish this book by tomorrow night, but I'm going to try. So I started Bright Side, and I'm 10% in. It's going well so far. I did leave this room today, I swear. I even went outside for like 1.5 hours and read out there. I'm just always in here because when Sam's home, I don't want him to hear me, and this is the furthest room away from his desk where he's working, so he can't hear me, hopefully. Let's get back to reading. Actually, I'm gonna finish watching Larry's 24-hour readathon. Bye. Surprise, it's 1 hour later and I'm still in my room. I swear, I leave my room. Library haul. So first, I'm so excited about this one, A Good Girl's Guide to Murder. Recently, I've been seeing a lot of people have been rereading this or reading it for the first time because it's turning into a show or movie. I'm not sure which one. And it's always sounded good to me. I just hadn't gotten to it. So I finally put it on hold at the library and it was ready today. Basically, it's about this girl, Pip, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, she has a senior project in high school and she decides to reinvestigate a case about this girl whose boyfriend killed her, supposedly. And it's just her journey trying to figure out what actually happened to them. And it's part of a series. So, it looks like a pretty quick read, and this is actually on my July TBR, which will make it the first book I have read this month on my July TBR if I finish it. But I'm not gonna be reading it in this video. Maybe that will be my next video. Then I have Mad Honey. This was popular a few months ago and it took pretty long for me to get it at my new library because they don't have as many resources, sadly. This is the large print, which I'm excited about because look at those words. Ginormous, I love it. I just can't see, okay? I need the words to be big, I'm getting old. I don't even know what this is about. I just remember Brooke Michio recommending this months ago. And then it was maybe a book of the month forever ago, which is why it became popular. Also, this is a very popular author. Jodi Picoult? I don't know how to say her name. I've read a lot of Jodi's books, so. What is it about? Then one day, Olivia receives a phone call. Lily is dead and Asher is being questioned by the police. But as the case against him unfolds, she realizes it is, can I speak? She realizes he's hidden more than he shared with her. Wait, that sounds good too. Maybe I will read both of them. Pretty exciting stuff. Back to watching TV, I'm gonna be honest, I'm not reading right now. Hopefully tonight.
Also, I don't know why I wanna read this book because I know it's sad. Bright Side by Kim Holden. And after the last time I filmed this video, it's giving me flashbacks to 1,000 Boy Kisses. Insert footage here.
Oh my god. Oh, things are not going well.
So, I'm not prepared. I'm really not. I think I might read one more chapter and just honestly call it quits for the night. Kind of just want to watch TV. Been doing a lot of reading. Bye. Hey guys. I look crazy. I ran 5 miles this morning and the best part was my knees didn't hurt. I felt fine running it. I didn't feel amazing, but I'm really proud of myself and now I am exhausted. Look, I literally can't even breathe. I ate lunch, been drinking tons of water, got a little coffee on the way home at Sam's favorite coffee spot since we were on that side of town for the first time in a while. And I'm gonna be honest, I think I'm just gonna call it quits right now on the challenge. Technically, I have until the end of today to read, but I really don't feel like using my brain at all. I just wanna watch TV. There's a lot of YouTube videos that just got posted, and I started watching season 2 of Cruel Summer, and it's really good so far. I just completely sweat through my shirt on the run, and then when I got home, I was freezing because my sweat was making me cold, so I just had this little blanket. Don't worry, I'm gonna wash it, but I'm gonna go get in the shower. Quick recap on my video. I want to read this book so bad since I'm a mood reader and I just don't really want to read any of my books on the Kindle right now. So, I did finish 3 books, not 6, 3 books in a week. I started off slow because I was reading a book that I didn't like, and so whenever I'm reading a book I don't like, it takes me forever to get through it. It was Our Scorching Summer, 2.5 stars. I've seen other people rave about this book, so I would definitely recommend it. It just wasn't for me. Then I went to Never Lie by Freda McFadden, 5 stars. Such an amazing thriller by her. And then most recently, I finished Done and Dusted, which was a small town cowboy romance, and I loved it. I've never read a cowboy romance, and 5 out of 5 stars. So, and then I'm currently, I think I got to 20% of Bright Side by Kim Holden, and I'm liking it so far. But you guys unfortunately don't get to see me cry on this video like I did in my last challenge video because I hear it's really sad. I'll let you guys know maybe in an upcoming video how I liked that book. Other than that, I am chilling today. So if you guys are still here, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to go listen to my podcast with my sister-in-law, Katie. I'll link it down below. Follow me on Goodreads, follow my Book Talk account, and like this video. And subscribe down below for more reading content coming your way. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.
My friend nostalgia, I found you when I heard the sweet sound of the ones who